Welcome user, in the last video we have seen how we can access, remove and add any feature and observation to the table. In this video we are going to see how the exploratory data analysis is going to help us to know about our data and to make optimized ML model. So let us start. Over here you can see purposes of exploratory data analysis. The first purpose is to find out central tendency of data distribution. In that we are going to see mean, median and mode terms. And also we are going to check how these terms are going to help us to decide behavior of data. The second purpose is to find out measure of dispersion. The terms range, variance and standard deviations will give us how data is distributed and how the data is related to each other. The third purpose is to check how much data is skewed by checking skewness properties and how much data is having pickedness by checking curtices. And the last and fourth purpose is to check how the different graphs are providing useful information to us. In this video, we are going to see QQ plot, histogram, scatter plot, box plot and bar graph. These all are the purposes of EDA. And do remember, we have to perform this operation on each and every individual column before going to apply any machine learning algorithm. Otherwise, there are high chances to get inaccurate model. To get more idea, let us discuss each purpose one by one. First purpose is central tendency. Over here, you can see the terms mean, median and mode. Mean is nothing but sum of collections of numbers divided by number of entries. Right here, I have calculated mean of 1 to 10 numbers and I got mean value is 5.5. Median is nothing but middle value of sorted list of numbers. And mode is most commonly occurring value in the distribution. The next question is how we are going to use this information for our analysis. Over here in example, I have only changed last entry with 45. And if I calculate mean value now, value of mean is 9. That is very high. From this analysis, we can say one high value or low value will create influence in whole dataset. And we can say such values are outliers for our datasets. Outliers would be maximum or minimum. But the next question is how we can decide that particular value is outlier or not. Actually, to decide outliers, there are several ways. And those all ways we are going to see in our upcoming videos. But most common method to check outlier is with the help of box plot. And after detecting outlier, either we have to delete that outlier or we have to replace that outlier. But do remember, deleting is not a good option. We will lose information. Now let us move towards the second purpose. Right here you can see formulas of variance, standard deviation and range. Variance is nothing but average of square difference from the mean, and standard deviation will measure how far away our data set from mean. And range is nothing but difference between maximum value and minimum value. Over here you can observe the mathematical equation of variance and standard deviation for population and sample data. If we check variance formula for population, sigma square is variance, x is the observation from the population, mu is mean of population, n is total number of observations from the population. And if we check variance formula for sample, s square is variance, x is observations from the sample, mu is mean of the sample, n is the total number of observations from the sample. Over here only minus 1 is added in the formula. Basically sample is subset of population, and to represent variance and standard deviation of population near to variance and standard deviation of sample, formula is having difference. Standard deviation is just square root of variance. Now let us discuss what information we are getting from standard deviation. Generally most of the data follow Gaussian or normal distribution, or the curve which is looking like bell having a certain properties called as an empirical formulas. The first formula will specify the probability of the variable falls within the range of mu minus sigma and mu plus sigma, which is basically my range of first standard deviation and which will approximately cover 68% of data points. Second formula will specify probability of variable falls within the range of mu minus 2 sigma and mu plus 2 sigma, which is basically my range of second standard deviation and which will approximately cover 95% of data points. And third formula will specify probability of variable falls within the range of mu minus 3 sigma and mu plus 3 sigma, which will approximately cover 99% of data points. The next purpose is giving information about skewness and curtices. We are going to calculate skewness and curtices for each column to know about the data. Whether the data is positively skewed, data is negatively skewed, or it is normal. You can see mathematical form of skewness and curtices, where x is input variable, mu is mean, sigma is standard deviation, and n is the number of observations. If value of skewness is greater than 0, then data is positively skewed. If value of skewness is less than 0, then data is negatively skewed. And if skewness is equal to 0, then data is normally distributed. Same when value of curtices is greater than 0, then it's positive curtices. If value is less than 0, then it's negative curtices. And if value of curtices is equal to 0, then it's normal distribution. And also we can decide type of data by looking into the graphical representation of the data. Let us discuss step by step. Consider first graph. Now draw the line which shows peak point. Identify where tailing end is located. Whenever graph is having tail end on the right side of peaky point line, then we can say values are greater than 0 or we are having a positively skewed data. If line is equally being ended on both sides, then we can say skewness value is 0 or data is normally distributed or symmetrically distributed. Same logic you can apply for negatively skewed data. Over here you can note the summary which shows the difference between positively skewed data, negatively skewed data and symmetrical data. One important point you can note, in positively skewed data, outliers are present on the right side of the graph. And in case of negatively skewed data, outliers are present on the left side of the graph. And if data is symmetrical, then there is no outliers. If you talk about curtices, for positive curtices, degree of peakedness is more. For negative curtices, degree of peakedness is less. For symmetrical data, curtices value is 0. Now I am going to talk about last purpose, that is graphical representation. In this purpose, we are going to see bar graph, histogram, QQ plot, scatter diagram and box plot. Let us discuss each graph one by one. Over here, you can see simple bar chart. We can plot bar chart horizontally as well as vertically. Here I have plotted vertical graph. X axis is independent variable shows a particular label and Y axis will show the count of that particular label. Bar chart will show good graphical representation when data is having less observation. But I would like to recommend never choose a bar chart for a huge data set. The next graph is histogram. Histogram is nothing but bar which are used continuous class interval or the graph which group the data into bins. But how we are going to use histogram to get information from data, let us see. If we fit the corner of histogram, then we can say tailing end is located at left side. So we can say data is negatively skewed and having outliers on left side. We can fit histogram by using histfit function in the MATLAB. And also if we check peakedness, we conclude data having positive curtices. And at the end, we can say data is not normally distributed. Next plot is QQ plot. Over here, you can check the graph. If all data points are near to line, then data is normal. And there are few points are away from the line. Maybe we can assume these are our outliers. Next plot is scatter diagram. Scatter diagram or plots provides a graphical representation of the relationship of two continuous variables. By looking into the scatter diagram, we can say strength of data, direction of data, or we can decide data is linear or not. And the next plot is box plot. With the help of box plot, we can decide whether the outliers are present in the data set or not. Over here you can see various sections of box plot. In normal distribution, both whisker will consume 50% of data and remaining 50% of data will be covered by quartile 1 to quartile 3. You can see formulas to find out values of upper bound and lower bound. IQR is nothing but interquartile range. Length of whisker will decide data type distribution. Any data point which is away from upper extreme or lower extreme that we are going to call as an outlier. Now let us see how whisker length will decide type of data distribution. If the whisker length is symmetrical at both ends, we can say data is symmetrically distributed. If whisker length is more at left side, then our data is negatively skewed. And if whisker length is more at right side, then our data is positively skewed. So this is all about the graphical representation and this will end our video. To get more information about central tendency, measure of dispersion and graphical representation, check our free MATLAB fundamental course. So in this video, we have seen how exploratory data analysis is going to help us to know about our data and to make optimized ML model. In the upcoming videos, we are going to see each and every purpose of exploratory data analysis and we are going to analyze each purpose in the MATLAB. In the upcoming videos, I have used two datasets to show variations. For first purpose, I have used simple dataset that I have created for testing purpose. For remaining purposes, I have used same data that shows how these purposes are related to each other. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any queries, post them in the comments and get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future. MATLAB is our future. Happy MATLABing.